Okay, the link to this tutorial can be found in the description. The first thing we are going to do is set the weather. So go into environment, and I just went into the wrong thing. Go into environment, go into clouds. We're going to set a ceiling of 750 feet. And get rid of that upper layer. An overcast ceiling with a thickness of 3,000 feet. Click apply, then OK. Go into environment again, into weather conditions. We're going to set the visibility to 1 mile. That is 1,600 meters. Approximately. So keep going up the layers until, well, you reach that layer there. And change the layer that says 6,000 to 4,000. Because you wanted to have a different visibility at 4,000 feet. So at 4,000 feet, you want 30,000 meters. Click apply, then OK, and note the visibility has indeed changed. Go into equipment instrument settings and set the altimeter to 2909 or 7. Because if you have loaded up with fair weather, that is the setting you will need. Here's the flight, the route. I like to use the low en route chart because it declutters the chart. Makes it easier to see the VORs and fixes. Okay, we got the San Jose VOR at 114.3. So I'm going to set my radio by, whoops, I don't need to pan the camera at all. Just zoom out one increment, and now you can change that knob with up and down. Oh, while you're doing this, before you start, it's a good idea to set the parking brake, or you'll get blown off the runway, kind of like I did. I just didn't capture that part. Okay, going back to the route here, we're looking at the Oakland VOR. It has a frequency of 116.8, and it should be in NAV2 active. We went the 114 outbound course, or radial. This will allow us to identify where we are and then pass east of Meissen Fix. Here I am, and I have set it in NAV1 standby mistakenly, and I'm going to fix that in a minute. And now my chart is glitching up. I'm trying to fix it here. Okay, we're going to set the course settings on the OBS knob. setting, tuning the ADF to the Riega NDB. And switch that to active and turn it on. Setting the heading bug to 310 to maintain runaway heading until I reach the route, until I get on the 009er radio for San Jose. An intake WR will come in handy for marking my location. So I'm going to continue preparing the radios. It has a frequency of 116. I will want that in NAV2 as well, to mark when I intercept soon on this. And once you've done that, you can start it up. So I'm going to enrich in the mixture, and when these are already set to boost, I can fire the starter. So I can increase my speed. I need to climb at about 75 knots. And activate the autopilot. It will capture my climb rate. And switch it to heading mode. Now I'm going to dial in my desired altitude of 4,000 feet. Click the arm button. Next, I'm going to click the barometer button and set it to match the altimeter so that it knows what my altimeter is set at.